It's the 2K Sports Pregame Show.
Good evening, sports fans. This is 2K Sports. Ernie Johnson, Shaquille O'Neal, Kenny Smith. And the pregame warm-ups wrapping up out there in Cleveland, where it'll be the Cavaliers against the Toronto Raptors. For Toronto, they're sitting at 500 over the last 10 games, kind of treading water. They'd really like to make a splash over the next few games. An intriguing matchup tonight. Two smart, experienced ball clubs. Shaq, how do you see this one playing out?
Solid execution on both sides. Each guy playing to his own strengths.
Okay. I think it's going to be more tactical, though, honestly. You know, if the game is played at a fast pace, that's when the benches come into play, because we'll see who has the bigger bench. You okay? You all right?
Oh.
You all right?
Man, no, I'm not.
Okay.
Oh. Kevin Harlan, take it away.
Oh, sorry, Ernie. You go down the wrong pipe.
Something did.
If it's the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, it can only mean one thing. Welcome to Cleveland, Ohio. Everyone is in their seat here at the Quicken Loans Arena in Cleveland as the Cavaliers look to grab a win here at home. Joined in the booth with Greg Anthony and Brent Berry, this is Kevin Harlan, our sideline reporter, David Aldridge. After this one game on the road, the Raptors will head back to Toronto.
They like their chances, but this could be a tough game for them.
Facing up against a talented roster, they'll have to show that they're the better team.
And for the Raptors, they've looked decidedly average here in the early stages of the season. And that's shocking when you consider the kind of success they're coming off from a year ago.
And they're going to have to step up their execution in a big way if they hope to come close to having the same success as they did last year. The good news for them is it's early and they have the luxury of time to get things sorted out.
And nothing tips off a broadcast like getting the lowdown from the sidelines. And we've got David Aldridge there for that. David, good evening.
Well, guys, it's hard to remember now, but Kevin Love didn't enter the league as a three-point shooter. Yet it's become a cornerstone of his game. The coaches have told him if you're a big man and you can shoot it out there, you're a valuable commodity. Kevin, he has listened, and he is indeed valuable.
Well, in this game today, it's all about court spacing, D.A. Thanks for the report. Here at the midway point, what we begin to realize now, there were some underrated pickups in the offseason that are showing what they can do.
Now, these are the kind of moves where at the end of the year you start thinking about candidates for executive of the year because they've plugged some holes. They've had an acquisition that's made their bench deeper, and we start to see in an 82-game season that maybe in the 55th to 57th game, a pickup like that is helping them win ball games. This is where those guys earn their money, the general manager.
Not wholesale changes. Just one guy can change a team slightly, and that nuance pays off.
Oh, anything subtle like that, that's where really you tip your hat to the general managers who understood that at some point during the year, we're going to lean on this player. Mm-hmm.
All fueled up and ready to go. Let's check out who's on the floor, courtesy of Gatorade. So for Toronto right now, we've got Johnson. Powell is out there with Lowry, and it's Marc Gasol. And it's Siakam in at the four. It's stolen by Lowry. Launches a three. The shot will not fall. Cavaliers go the other way with it.
They couldn't put the pieces together, losing that last matchup with Boston.
You know, they're the visiting team. It's a loud arena, very distracting at times, but simply no excuse for missing a ton of free throws.
Yeah, it just looked like, and I'm not sure if you guys saw this, but just never comfortable in this game. And the line certainly is one of those places where that could show up.
The Cavaliers shooting their first free throw tonight.
And as a unit, they're shooting 78% from the line. That's a solid number to work with on the season.
One shot, gentlemen.
And here's Lowry. He'll bring it up for Toronto. It's a three-point game. outside Gasol. That's in, coming off an assist from Lowry.
And that's what makes Lowry a great floor leader, just unselfish in his attitude and great awareness of how to keep his teammates involved.
And for the Cleveland Cavaliers in this roster, Brent, a lot of sharpshooters that can get hot at any time.
Well, third in the league last season in made threes, and the team does a really good job of drawing and kicking and finding shooters. And they had the fifth best rated offense last year, mostly because of how well they shot the ball from distance.
Here's Lowry, following the score by Cleveland. Just over a minute and a half played here in this one. To the wing on the left, pass to Siakam. Fires from deep, and the Raptors hit again from deep.
And that's exactly what he's looking for, draining the triple.
Clarkson passes to Shakenbeck. Back to Clarkson. Now the pass to Shakenbeck. Just five to shoot. He kicks it to Nance. From deep. The shot by Clarkson, no good.
And a really smart defender there. He just reads the play, wastes no time trying to blow it up.
And what I like best is that he does it completely under control. Really gives the shooter nowhere to turn to.
Here's Shake and Bake. And you can see his scoring totals. Those are some pretty good numbers. He's putting up close to 15 points a game on average. Clarkson looking for an opening. Bucket is good.
Nice way to start the evening. His number's getting called, and for good reason.
Well, this is also one of those things where you start to think about how you're going to change your defense already. If at all possible, make someone else beat you.
And here are the Raptors now. The Cavaliers making the shot. Two open that time. Made it look too easy. Lowry's got himself on the board with three there.
The defense cannot let guys get into that kind of comfort zone. You have to patrol the three-point line or you risk getting burned.
Now, here's Clarkson. He had a 27-point outing in their last game against Boston. And he gets the whistle. Two free throws coming up.
You got to be cautious when you guard Clarkson. He's got a good burst. And when he gets assertive like that, oftentimes will draw a foul.
It's his first trip to the line.
Two shots.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
That one is off. One of my favorite moves is the Euro step. I know it's one of yours as well. There are a lot of guys that can do it well.
Well, I got to see Manu Ginobili step around me for years in San Antonio. But I think James Harden is still the most devastating Euro step player we have in the game. There's something about the lefties, isn't there, Kevin? We have a hard time figuring
they throw
a lefty
you off.
Out.
They yeah. throw you off automatically just by the left hand.
Right.
Then
yeah.
they add the little sidestep.
And James Harden with the shiftiness and the way he moves the ball around and draws contact. I know there are a lot of people that get aggravated by that, but he's nearly impossible to stop, especially when he's got his passport with the Eurostep.
He slithers. Count that one. Lynn's got his first basket of the night.
Timely passing leads to assists, and that's been the recipe for success.
Clarkson finds Nance. And here in the first quarter, with a little over 3.5 minutes played, here's Henson, and John Henson with the slam.
Well, this is where Henson gets plenty of his points trolling the offensive glass.
And so Van Vliet will bring it up for the Toronto Raptors. Lynn against Clarkson. There's the triple. Rebound collected by Clarkson. Cavaliers trailing. That's going to be over and back. Not watching for the line that time. Now we get a chance to check out the standings out east already. We are in December. Look at Toronto. They're sitting eighth right now in the early going. And, of course, Cleveland a game behind.
And for the Raptors, they basically lived up to the expectations so far this season. And that's not really good news for their fan base because those expectations only had them on the brink of the playoffs.
Unfortunately, those expectations were right on the money. They just weren't ready to join that elite group of teams at the top of this league. And they're still in the playoff picture, and we all know anything can happen in the postseason.
Clock is at three. Here's Henson, and it's good. With time running down on the shot clock.
That's a pretty good move, Henson. I'll tell you what, being assertive when he has the ball like that, that's another dimension to the offense on the inside that they could use.
Now here's Lynn. Looking at his numbers, he averages a bit over 9 points a game. From 11 feet away, good as the jump shot falls. Lynn's got his second basket of the game.
And Lynn is just fearless, always looking to get as close to the bucket as he can.
Timeout is called, first of the game for the Cavaliers.
And for Lynn, missing the season last year, he's just glad to be back. His playmaking and creativity is something that this team needs. As long as he's healthy and playing aggressively, he'll be an effective guard option.
Different look now for Cleveland. Porter comes in for Nance. And J.R. Smith subbed in for Clarkson. Porter, bounce pass. Smith kicks to Thompson. Smith, the pass to Sexton. Down to five on the shot clock. The kick out to Porter. Cleveland moving the ball around. Goes back up. He gets it in there.
And another momentum shift. These teams going back and forth all night.
Yeah, which team's going to find some consistency first? Neither one can pull away.
Just 1 second between the shot clock and game clock. Smith against Lynn. It's stolen by Smith. And now the Cavaliers. Fast break. Smith with the ball. Shoots over Lynn. And the last shot at the buzzer doesn't go in for him. At the end of one, a closely contested game so far. Cavaliers ahead. They're up by one. It's the NBA on 2K Sports from Quicken Loans Arena. Now a veteran in the NBA, Serge Ibaka, talked about his role on this team.
I like to do all those little things, running up and down, blocking shot, straight to floor, making open shot, you know, rolling the basket, screen, you know, those dirty work, I like to do that.
And Ibaka, Greg, a great complimentary player.
And you like his combination of size and skill, able to impact the game at both ends on a high level.
And this has been a fairly close game through the first quarter, and we'll see what happens here in the second. And taking a look at the Cavaliers' performance here, what do you guys see?
Well, to me, the story of that first period was their rebounding.
Yeah, jumping out to a lead largely because they did the hard work on the glass. So you love the passion in the early part of this game that they're playing with.
Setting the floor for the Raptors. We've got Jeremy Lin. Baca is out there with Hollis Jefferson. And it's Siakam in at the power forwards position. Let's go now to the sideline and catch up with David Aldridge.
Hey, guys. Well, Marc Gasol is the more fiery of the Gasol brothers. Pau Gasol says, I sugarcoat things a little more than Marc. He's more emotional, more direct. And Marc said, when a mistake happens on defense, I know you're not concentrating. I don't allow that. He knows controlling his frustration is important. He says, I'm working on it. Guys?
Art of leadership, DA. Thank you.
That was some very intimidating, aggressive defense that really helped alter that shot.
And finished off by Porter.
Ooh, that's as forceful a finish as you're ever going to see out of this guy.
Well, gee, it adds now to their lead in spectacular fashion.
And to me, this is why they're winning, guys. Unlikely players stepping up huge against a defense that's really nowhere to be found.
So, timeout called here, the first for Toronto. We've heard Coach Steve Kerr say the power forward position, as we knew it, is disappearing. You could say that maybe about the center position, too.
I don't want to say that about the center position. What I want to tell you, Kevin, in my humble opinion, is that the center position has changed.
It's evolving.
So, yeah, I don't want to say that it's just disappeared, because right. There are players out there that are playing that position and doing a lot of the things that you would qualify as center-centric, screening, going down to the block, rim running to the post, being an option down low. But it's definitely changed.
But now we're seeing him go out and defend smaller guys in the perimeter, taking threes. And that's what's weird for your eyes, to just kind of absorb what's going on.
Well, it's weird to absorb not only that and what those players individually are asked to do, but when you're at a game and you're sitting in the stands and all of a sudden you see five guys that are outside the three-point line. I mean, go back to the game in the 80s. It's the exact opposite. It was like, you know, a bunch of ants on top of a lost candy bar sitting in the lane, gnawing at one another.
Right, right.
It's just changed. So the center position, not disappeared, just changed.
Love's check-in for the Cavaliers. Shake and Bake comes in for Sexton. A new group in now for the Raptors. Marc Gasol's checked in for Siakam. Johnson comes in for Hollis Jefferson. Norman Powell's checked in for Jeremy Lin. And Kyle Lowry subbed in for Fred VanVleet. For Cleveland, they have shot 2 of 3 from the free throw line tonight.
Two shots.
And that one misses. No good at the stripe this time. Second misses also. Raptors trail by 5. Lowry feeling it out a bit. Passes it to Powell. And too much time in the lane. They get called for the 3-second violation.
And let's take a quick look now at some stats for Love. He's really stood out for them over the past month. Averaging about 16 points, 9 rebounds, and 2 assists. Just solid all-around performances we've been seeing from him, delivering night in and night out.
And I like it when stars do exactly that. It's not just about scoring 50 or 40 or 30. It's about making plays consistently.
Here's Shake and Bake. 5-point lead, the biggest of the game. And there's the foul. It goes on Serge Ibaka. That is his first foul of the game. We're now about 2 minutes into the second quarter. Now, here is Smith, guarded by Powell. Clock at 4. Fires for 3. Toronto grabs the miss. Last time they met was in Toronto.
Well, I mean, they lost their last matchup with this team, and foul trouble really plagued them throughout the game.
Yeah, they had a few important guys sitting there on the bench at a time when they really could have used them on the floor. They have to play much more in control here tonight.
Here in the second quarter, we've played a little over 2.5 minutes now. Here's Shake and Bake, now recovering. Here's Shake and Bake, and the shot falls short this time.
Now, somehow, some way, he couldn't get that one to fall from in between. Got to take advantage of the weak defense when you can.
Lowry dishes to Powell. Johnson outside. Second shot opportunity. Connects. The jumper drops. Johnson's got 4 points this quarter. For Cleveland, they've gone 2 of 5 from the field here in the second quarter, shooting 40%.
When you watch Kyle Lowry play, you see how much bigger he is than his stats. He does so many little things on both ends of the floor. I mean, he's a great screen setter, takes charges, all the things that don't necessarily show up in the stat sheet but are important when it comes to winning.
Yeah, strength and attitude there on the glass shown by Kevin Love.
And so Lowry will bring it up for Toronto. Only given up 6 here in this quarter. They'll host the Denver Nuggets after this one. That game marks the first half of a quick 2-game homestand. Now here is Lowry. Steady offensive output from him, averaging more than 16 points a game. From the arc, and the 3-ball is good. Lowry's got it all tied up now for the Raptors. And Greg, with Lowry, it isn't like he's quiet on the stat sheet either.
Yeah, he is a bulldog. I mean, he scores it, the playmaking. He's just complete in terms of a backcourt player. Rebounds as well as anybody for his position, and got good hands on defense. It just gives you a little bit of everything at that point guard position.
Timeout called, Cleveland. Different look now for Cleveland. Harry Nance has checked in for Hanson, and it's Clarkson in for Smith. Here is Love. They count on his contributions, currently providing 16.5 points a game. Some nice passing by Cleveland here. Pass to Clarkson. 6 on the shot clock. Shoots over Powell, and another miss by Cleveland.
Something that's kept this game close is the fact that the rebound stats for both teams are almost identical.
Outside Lowry. To the left wing. Pass to Powell. Kicks it to Gasol. And trying for the go-ahead basket, it doesn't go in. Cavaliers have gone 3 of 8 from the field since the beginning of the second quarter. The pass to Shaken. Back to Clarkson. Nance outside. From outside the arc. The Cavaliers again can't hit. Toronto's gone 4-6 from outside the arc tonight. 41 seconds left in the first half of the game. Powell with it. He's coming off a 13-point game against Golden State. Played in with a nice touch off the glass. Powell's got his first basket.
And those close-range shots are what you want him taking. They always have a great chance of falling.
There's Shake and Bake. 12 seconds left to play here in the second quarter. Here's Love, and misses it off the right side of the rim. And a close game so far through the first two quarters as we reach halftime. Raptors lead by 2. It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Thank you, Kevin. Kyle, a good first half for you all. How do you continue that for the rest of the game?
We got to come out with our energy. We got to come out and play our game and keep going out there and pushing. Our defense and everybody's rotating, so we're playing together right now.
We'll see if you stay connected in the second half. Thanks. Back to you, Kevin.
Thank you, David. And we'll be back for the third quarter of action following halftime.
And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hello, folks. Good to have you back. Ernie Johnson with Kenny the Jet Smith. and the Big Diesel, Shaquille O'Neal. Welcome to the NBA Halftime Show on 2K Sports. The first quarter for the Raptors was fairly even. Some good action during the period, as it was just a one-point game at the end of one. The second quarter was a tight battle, but they were the slightly better team. Not by very much, however. And taking a look at the Raptors, Kenny, what did you see out there?
Well, the three-point shooting was the key thus far. When you're knocking down those shots from the perimeter, it really spreads the floor. You demand respect from the defense. We'll see if they can keep it flowing in the second half.
Shaq, how do you think Cleveland played?
What impressed me the most was the effort they put into the offensive glass. Second chance points really added up for them. Fighting through box outs, battling for position, they owned the offensive boards.
And that'll about do it as we get ready for the second half. Let's take you down to Kevin Harlan.
Shout out to my man Joel.
Joel, what up?
As we return a look at the corner of Euclid and East 6th in downtown Cleveland, just a few blocks from our spot here at Quicken Loans Arena. And we're halfway through this one. Plenty of basketball left in a game that's been fairly even so far. One of the stories here, Kyle Lowry getting it done today.
And you know he's going to come out aggressive, and you do what you can to slow him down, and thus far it hadn't worked because he's been amazing.
Even though we expect this kind of stuff from him night after night, it doesn't make it any less extraordinary to watch it in person.
We've got second half action for you, and if the next couple quarters are similar to the first, this one could go down to the last possession. Love is the four with Thompson in the middle. Shaking big out there with Clarkson. And it's Nance in at the small forward position. That's the five to begin the second half for Larry Drew. Love the pass to Shaking big. Here's Clarkson. And no good. Had a chance to take the lead there.
He's got to know not to take that shot when he's so closely defended.
Now, here's Lowry. He has six. He kicks it to Johnson. In the corner, Powell with it. Knocks down the three ball. Powell's got the first basket of the second half. That one for Toronto. The Cavaliers trail by five. Here's Shake and Bake. Down low. Here's Love. Basket good. Love's got his second bucket.
Kevin, stick-to-itiveness. You heard that? Kevin Love just showed you what it's all about.
Outside Lowry. Offside Gasol. And there are the Raptors with another bucket.
Textbook. Nice pass. Great catch. Even better finish.
Down low and taken away by Johnson. Here's Lowry. Powell kicks to Siakam. And it's off from three-point range. The Cavaliers shooting well. They're at 45%. Clarkson finds Love. That one doesn't go. And Toronto will come the other way. And Lowry has it in the corner. It's good. Only a few seconds into the shot clock. Lowry's got eight.
A one-man show offensively, and that's almost always good news for his team.
To the paint, Shake and Bake. That's in there. Love with the assist.
Kevin Love, great recognition as to what was happening there. Saw the floor, saw the teammate, and saw the passing opportunity.
Toronto calls timeout. Across the board, Brent, it's hard to find an offensive weapon as efficient as Kevin Love.
Well, he doesn't have the highest shooting percentage for a big man, but his impact is huge because of how many threes he takes and how many threes he ultimately makes. When he gets locked in with that kind of shot, he can explode for some huge numbers. We've seen that in the past.
different look now for Cleveland. Henson checked in for Love. Smith comes in for Jordan Clarkson. And it's Sexton in for Shake and Bake. And then for Toronto, Hollis Jefferson's checked in for Stanley Johnson. Jeremy Lin comes in for Norman Powell. And it's Fred VanVleet in for Kyle Lowry. And the foul on John Henson. That is his first foul of the game. Here is Lin. Hollis Jefferson passes to Siakam. Buries the long-range jumper. Siakam's got his second basket of the night.
This is the kind of guy that you wake up in a cold sweat the night before you play him. Just a matchup nightmare. Tricky, confident, and he takes on all comers.
That one's good, and the Raptor lead is cut down to just 6 points and the bucket from Smith. And here's Lin. He'll bring it up for the Raptors. ...11 feet away, and another basket for Toronto. 3 minutes gone now in the third quarter. The Cavaliers have gone 3-5 to start the second half, developing a nice rhythm out there. Smith kicks to Thompson. Here's Henson, and that one is good. Henson's got six.
And defensively, they are on their heels every time the ball comes inside.
VanVleet looking around. Outside Gasol. And the Raptors hit again from deep.
And really, as the three-pointers keep dropping, you get the sense that the frustration is mounting for the defense.
Thompson passes to Sexton. And it's off the back rim, no good.
A slight advantage for them in the rebound department, but that oftentimes is all it takes.
And how about breaking out the Statue of Liberty on that dunk?
A nice way to pad that lead a little more, you're right. Here's Sexton after the Raptors pick up two. And the jam by Larry Nance.
Yeah, this is a nice connection with Larry Nance Jr. Throw it his way, he'll take care of the rest.
And that Unleash Chaos replay presented by Under Armour. Hover Havoc, giving us a chance to relive that exciting play. Gasol. No good that time. Good D by Thompson. The Cavaliers trail by 9. Here's Smith. Count it from 12. Smith's got 4 points now in the quarter.
Yeah, you don't want J.R. Smith to get room to shoot, especially from the mid-range there. He's very effective at scoring just about anywhere on the floor.
Here's VanVleet, still looking for his first bucket in this one. Gasol. It's rebounded by Cleveland. Thompson's got rebound number 5 here tonight. And Nance kicks to Thompson. 54 seconds left here in the third quarter. 6 to shoot. And here's Sexton. He provides a good amount of offense for the team, averaging around 11.5 points a game. Thompson misses.
The defense was in the area, but not really effective. Has to put away this layup.
Lin against Smith. Pass to Gasol. Over Thompson. Pulled the shot a little left, but the bounce goes his way. 10 points for Mark Gasol.
Yeah, he's a heady player. He knows how to get himself going and giving his team a real advantage right now on the offensive end.
The Cavaliers trail by 9. Now Sexton. Henson in the corner. Up in time. And that would have counted, but his shot was off the mark this time. The third quarter comes to a close. Toronto ahead, up by 9. And time for the short break, and stay right where you are. The fourth quarter is coming up next. And while we can now, let's take a look at today's State Farm assist of the game.
And he sliced the D wide open with his feed. They had no chance to prevent that basket.
That's what great passing will do for you right there, dissecting the defense with that play.
And with three quarters behind us, let's see what this fourth period holds in store for us. Raptors leading by nine, setting the floor for the Raptors. We've got Ibaka. Powell is out there with Lowry. Then it's Johnson, and it's Siakam in at the four slot. Ibaka, no luck.
You're not going to see that very often. Plenty of space, but he just, let's face it, he whiffs on that.
Shake and bake passes to Thompson. Inside. And Thompson throws it down.
Well, with Tristan's motor and that kind of reach, great job on finishing off the alley-oop.
Pass to Ibaka. Here's Johnson, takes the 12-footer and hits. And the Raptors lead by nine. Johnson's gone a perfect 3-for-3 so far. Shake and bake passes to Thompson. About a minute played here in the fourth quarter. And Stanley Johnson is going to pick up the foul. That's foul number two for him. Here's Clarkson. The rebound by Johnson.
And getting a hand in the shooter's face, locking down that in-between area.
Just taking on the challenge on every possession. I love defenders who give nothing away.
Now here's Johnson. Here's Powell. He kicks it to Lowry. Just five to shoot. A tad short, but it's good off the front iron. And it's an 11-point Toronto lead.
And that in-between, Rage, is a shot Lowry uses to keep defenders off balance. As good as he is with the three ball or attacking at the rim, he still has that mid-range to fall back on.
Timeout called, Cleveland. The Cavaliers making a change here. Nance has checked in. And let's catch up with our sideline reporter, David Aldridge.
Thanks, guys. I got a chance to hear what the Cavaliers head coach was saying to his team. He said, "Do you want this game? Don't tell me about it. Show me and show your teammates. We've got to play better and we've got to play harder if we're going to come back." Guys.
Now, here's Clarkson. And there's the foul. It goes on Serge Ibaka. That'll be his second foul of the game.
Well, near the basket, sometimes you got to do some things with the basketball just to get it up on the glass. Pretty creative shot there from Jordan.
One shot, mind the lanes.
Thompson no good on the free throw. Greg, what are some of the positives that Tristan Thompson's play brings to the team?
Still a very efficient scorer on the shots that he does take, and he lives mostly inside the paint, and still a strong offensive rebounder. But his days of being a threat on the offensive end as the game has evolved seems to have kind of gone away.
Well, if Thompson is going to get that deep, you almost have to wrap two hands around him and hope he doesn't score.
Taking two shots.
Two,
And he makes the first.
Tristan Thompson is one of the best offensive rebounders in the NBA. So to do that, you can't be afraid to throw your weight around.
No good on the second, so he hits one of two.
You know, and Serge Ibaka, a player who kind of came into the league as a defensive stopper, shot blocker. You know, still has great length and can bother shots, but not the prolific shot blocker he once was, as the focus has become more on the offensive end.
Now, here's Lowry. He's tightly guarded. Ibaka dishes to Lowry. Raptors moving the ball around, and yes, it's good. Ibaka's got four this quarter. And with Ibaka, at one point, would average almost four blocks a game.
Yeah, I mean, it is hard for any player to maintain a pace that high at this stage. Ibaka's done well to adjust, I think, his capabilities and make sure he can still have an impact on defense. The block numbers won't ever be as gaudy as they once were, but he is still causing problems for shooters.
Love grabs the board. The Cavaliers trail by eight. Here's Shake and Bake. He feeds it to Thompson. Pass to Love. Here's Shake and Bake. Kicks it to Clarkson. Launches it. Buries it from three-point range.
This guy's a gamer.
Fourth quarter of play, and over 3.5 minutes have gone by. And the Raptors call time here.
And he could tell his guys were dragging a little bit, calling time out to kind of let them catch their breath.
Fans, you've got to get loud. Come on, let's have a round of applause for the Cavalier girls.
Now to recognize our Jordan player of the game, Kyle Lowry.
And he's just been crushing it from the field tonight, Kevin. Whether it's been on open looks or with the guy draped all over him, he just hadn't missed much. With his percentage in the sky-high range, they've had no choice but to make him their number one option on every trip.
And a little over 3.5 minutes in the books so far here in the fourth. Powell kicks to Lowry. Dishes it to Gasol. On the clock. Goes up on the high post. Raptors get it back. And a good offensive board. And he gets the bucket. Gasol's got 9 points now in just the second half. Love outside. The pass to Shaking. Cleveland needs to get a shot off here. Here's Clarkson. No good from outside.
And a really smart defender there. He just reads the play, wastes no time trying to blow it up.
And what I like best is that he does it completely under control. Really gives the shooter nowhere to turn to.
Now here is Lowry. A baseline J. And it falls over the rim and in. And now a 9-point Raptor lead.
And somebody throw some cold water on Lowry. The man is on fire. He has taken this game over, and it doesn't look like he has any plans on slowing down.
Timeout called, the Cavaliers. They're trailing by 9. 1:14 left in the fourth quarter of this one. Nance in position. Outside Lowry. Thompson against Gasol. Over Thompson. No good from Gasol.
No doubt disappointed with that one. He'd love to have that one back.
Yeah, I'd put that play on repeat. The setup was perfect. Just need a better result next time.
Now here's Powell. Passes to Siakam. Powell with it. And Lowry has it in the corner. Down to 5 on the shot clock. And again, it's Toronto converting.
Yeah, with this lead, that's probably going to do it. Fans heading for the exits.
Now the team came in fired up from the opening tip. You see the focus. They're ready to do battle. All keyed right there from the lead pass. Right on the money.
And the dunk by Powell.
Running up the score. Showing no mercy.
Well, you want to close the door on any type of comeback effort. This has been a vault. Ka-ching!
You're right.
Two shots.
Good on the first, and that brings them to within 10. And so he hits both. And here's Lynn. He'll bring it up for Toronto. Outside Lowry. And so it's Toronto winning this one. A solid win on the road for them. This building was dead silent by the time GA this one wound down.
And that's what you want to do. Take the crowd out of it by crunch time. Don't give them any chance to lift their team up at the finish.
And now let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's standing by from the sideline. All right, Dave.
Thank you, Kevin. With Jeremy Lin, impressive team win tonight. What were your thoughts?
You know, I thought it was a great effort, 1 through 15. Everybody just coming out with high energy and playing team basketball.
The ball got going and it led to a big win, Jeremy. Thank you. Kevin, back to you.
David, thank you as always. Thank you for joining us. That'll do it for now. For Brent Berry, Greg Anthony, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. So long, everyone.